Today, I'm testing clickbait Minecraft hacks and tricks to see if they actually work or are actually fake. Watch until the end to see how many creators we expose. So, what exactly is clickbait about a shulker? We're gonna push it into the glass block. Yeah, I've seen that, been there, done that, got the t-shirt. That's not new, that's not clickbait. Wait, you're not gonna push it inside the chest, no. No way. Wait, it hides the chest? Nope, I refuse. This has to be clickbait. It has to be a command, a texture pack, a mod, something. Now, I know you can put any type of mob inside of a glass block. So that's why this works here when you do this. You can have a cute little shulker inside a glass block. And we'll put our piston here, our shulker, and then our chest. And I'm gonna show you this is fake. I do not believe this. This has to be clickbait. Yeah, wait, what? It didn't work. For a minute, it didn't work there, guys. And I was like, yep, I'm right. But then it's hidden. The shulker is literally hiding the chest right now. On this side, you can't even tell that there's a chest in there unless the shulker opens up. Can you use the chest still? Oh my gosh, you can open the chest while it's inside the shulker. If you put like a wall up on this side, like you imagine this is your house, guys, you could hide your chest full of all your diamonds and netherite using a shulker. I never thought of that before, but this is just pure genius. How to get maxed out trines 100% of the time? Using a shell? That's clickbait.
Welcome to Fact or Cap.
Oh, wait.
We test Minecraft videos that we see on our For You page to see if they're real.
Wait, that's what I'm doing. Wait a minute. It's not working, but this guy's testing it in Java Edition. The first clip was in Bedrock Edition. What? No. He's saying it's fake, but he didn't even test it in the right version. Now, he said it didn't work, but the first clip was in Bedrock Edition, which is like your iPhone, your iPad, whereas he tested it on Java Edition, which is your PC. So we're gonna jump down here into the ocean. We need to get a drowned with a trident here. Okay, there we go. We give him a Nautilus shell, and he picked it up and he dropped the trident. It does work. Guys, this TikToker double clickbaited us. He said the first video was clickbait and said it didn't work. He was wrong. It does work, guys. And this is why you should always just watch and subscribe to me, EY Stream. Why are you not subscribed yet? Wait for it. Okay, the classic text from any clickbait video. Why is this guy renaming his diamond and emeralds to netherite? Okay, just because you rename them doesn't mean that they suddenly become netherite. That would definitely be clickbait. His renaming his netherite to netherite. Explain why. This is makes no sense. Okay, he's throwing in lava. Yeah, say goodbye to those emeralds. Wait, did he just throw the emeralds into the lava and they aren't burning? Nothing's but. Well, I mean, netherite doesn't burn in lava, but why would renaming those things to netherite work? And he's throwing them to Nah, it has to be fake. It has to be fake. Even though they're renamed to netherite, netherite gets destroyed by cactus, guys. So that doesn't make sense at all. Because of that cactus, guys, I already know this is fake without a doubt. And then he throws them in the water, get destroyed. When you throw netherite into water, it doesn't get destroyed. It's fake. And basically, he just renamed a bunch of different minerals to netherite. We're just gonna test here with diamonds. So we got that. First off, he tested in fire, lava, cactus, water, and that's supposed to kill it. We'll put just one diamond because I'm certain this is gonna burn. Yep, the diamond got burned. Yep, there's the first clickbait. All right, and yep, didn't work in the lava either. Got destroyed by the cactus, and when I put in the water, oh, well, I missed the water. Let's pretend that didn't happen. Yep, it's totally fine. It didn't get destroyed whatsoever here, guys. So basically, that was clickbait. But I refuse to let you guys get clickbaited, so we're going to expose this creator, and I'll show you exactly how they did it. So how did they scam everybody out of hundreds of thousands of views? Well, they used these two bad boys. And in this case, yes, they are very bad because they were used to clickbait poor innocent viewers. They had a repeating always active command block that had the command you see in chat. And then they had a second always active repeating command block that basically means anytime an item hits water, it automatically kills that item and deletes it. First off, we'll throw in this stack of gold. And you can see, boom, it got totally destroyed. We're going to rename this to netherite. And we'll test it with all the minerals here so I can show you it works with all of the different items, guys. The diamonds to netherite as well. All right, there we go. All renamed. Now, if we go ahead and chuck in our gold, you guys can see. Okay, we need to. Okay, this is a little awkward to get. I need to get it right on the edge. There we go. You can see, even though it's in the lava, it's not burning. Have a check of that, guys. You can do it with the emeralds here. We can do it with the diamonds here. Even if I go ahead and get rid of all of my diamonds, all of my emeralds, all of my gold, if I walk into the lava, I can pick it all back up. None of them got damaged. I can do the same thing on the cactus here, guys. Chuck on all our diamonds, all our emeralds, all our gold. No problems whatsoever. Same with the fire. They are totally invincible, guys. We got invincible items. But then when we chuck them into the water, boom, disappeared, absolutely cucked, guys. And that, my friends, is how YouTubers get away with stealing views from us. How to walk through any block in 100% survival Minecraft. Guys, the full caps and the emojis make me feel like this is clickbait. Plus, that's not just any block, that is literally bedrock. Okay, so we get an elytra and then fly into any wall. Why would flying into a wall let you get through it here, guys? You fly into the wall and then you could just walk through the block. No, that has to be a texture pack, guys, where they've retextured air to Bedrock or something. So I'm back in Bedrock Edition, because that's supposedly the version that this hack works on. And part of me is beginning to believe that this might be real. Like, when they put on the Elytra, they didn't just use any Elytra. They actually had it enchanted, guys, with Unbreaking 3. That was something I noticed there. We're going to try it with a normal Elytra, and then we're also going to try it with the Unbreaking 3 like they did. Now, I built up a tower the exact same height as they had in the video, and then we're going to build a Bedrock wall here. Now, the bottom blocks have to be broken. That was important. We'll jump up here. Now we've got our Unbreaking 3 on Elytra. We've got to jump off and... Okay, well, that was awkward. It's survival for this to work, you guys. So we'll jump and fly and bang! Can we walk through the wall? Oh! Guys, look at that! I can walk through Bedrock! Yo, it's not clickbait. It's a legit bug that is in the game. But I want to see, does it work with normal Elytra as well? So will it work now? Okay, we'll fly in and bang. Oh, I can walk through it. Okay, I suppose you could use this to sneak into your friend's base if it was made out of Bedrock. In that case, they probably have creative mode. You could probably just break it in creative mode. But I don't know what the uses are for this, but it's still a pretty cool glitch. Removing end portal frames in survival Minecraft? You just grow a giant mushroom and it breaks the end portal frames? Does that mean you're able to pick up the end portal frames or it just destroys them? Okay, I don't think you can pick them up, so no decorating with end portal frames here, guys. But you could grow giant mushrooms on all sides of the end portal like they're doing here, which would just leave the portal behind, and then... Oh, you can decorate and get your own custom end portal. That's pretty snazzy, friends. So let's go ahead and do what they did. They had some dirt here. Now, they needed to clear out this space here so the mushroom was actually able to properly grow. So we'll go ahead and set air on this side, just like that. All right, there we go. And now we'll put our mushroom down and we'll use our bone mill. All right, there we go. Okay, grow. What? Are you kidding me? It doesn't destroy the end portal frame. Why not? It literally destroys all the other blocks around it, but not the end portal frame. I genuinely thought this worked. Why doesn't this work? Did I do something wrong? I'm gonna check the internet. And I can officially confirm that this is not clickbait. Check it out, guys. It does destroy the end portal frames. It literally just got removed from the game in 1.16.4. If you use any version lower, the mushrooms will still destroy the end portal frames and you'll be able to get your very own custom end portal. But it's kind of a shame. It literally just got deleted from the game. Minecraft WT bad word moment. What exactly are we doing here? We're pushing an end portal into a nether portal. How in the world did they even get an end portal vertical? That doesn't exist in Minecraft. I already think this is fake because of the commands here. Oh yeah, and it just makes a new portal that is an end mixed with the nether? Yeah, that is a joke. That is just clickbait. It's obviously clickbait here, guys, but we'll try it anyways. Okay, if we grab ourselves our two pistons, just like that, and then we'll bring the redstone around like they had here, guys. Basically, they would have had to use commands to go set block and then tilde, tilde, negative one, tilde, and then spawned in a nether portal. Just like that, and boom, we've got ourselves a nether portal on this side. Now, for the other side, they must have used a mod to get themselves a vertical end portal because it just doesn't exist. The closest thing you can get in vanilla Minecraft to a vertical end portal is an end gateway, I believe it is. Yep, there we go. And this one is a square portal. Now, I know we've got that purple beacon, but that'll disappear in just a second. Okay, there we go. It's disappeared here, guys. We don't have that giant beacon anymore, but as you can see, it's not quite a vertical end portal. They must have used a mod for that. And then when I go ahead and hit the pistons, they literally do nothing. They cannot push portal blocks. It's not in the game's code for them to be able to push portal blocks. So you can see right there, it's fake. Honestly, guys, I shouldn't need to show you that this is fake, but I am going to expose exactly how they clickbaited everyone. Guys, I feel really bad for siding with the clickbaiters, but I have to give them a little bit of credit because this was actually really, really difficult to set up and use some very complex commands. Basically, they set up exactly where they were planning to build this before the video. I've marked it out here, guys. Then, of course, guys, they used commands to bring in our end portal and our gateway. So we'll put in our nether portal there and our end gateway if we go ahead and spawn that in. Now, you can see here, guys, the color of the nether portal is just a little bit different. And that's because I used a texture pack, which is exactly what they did to get the changed nether portal color in the center when we pushed them together. And then there are the commands. Basically, guys, under this lever, we've got a single block that sets redstone just above this command block, and then another command block under here that turns that redstone back to air. This command block here sets block air on the nether portal, making it disappear so the piston can extend, and then this one sets air over on this end gateway so the piston can extend, basically meaning the pistons are actually able to move. As you saw before, they're not actually able to push those blocks. Then we have a comparator coming out of here, which goes into a repeating block, which sets a nether portal block right in the center here. Then on top of that, we went ahead and inside the nether, there's actually a block that automatically teleports you from the nether to the end the minute you enter in. I can't show you that because, well, once I enter the nether, it will teleport me there, and then we basically had to redo the entire end from scratch. They just literally replaced all of the end stone with nether bricks. You'll see guys in a second here. We activate that, it pushes it together. You walk into the nether, it automatically teleports you to the end here, guys. And just for a moment, I'm a little bit frozen here. My game is just loading because there is so much random stuff going on. But you can see I've replaced all of the end stone with netherracks. So they would have done this before the video started using world edit or something like that, guys. And then as you can see, if we fly out here now, we have ourselves our end nether concoction, disaster, mystery, whatever the world is going on here. As you can see, we've got it here. But the minute you actually go into the end gateway just over here, you will see that it literally only applies to this area, guys. If we jump out here, all they would have done is used world edit to replace the end stone by going //replace endstone and _stone with netherrack like that. And done that for basically the entire end to make it look as if it was a merged dimension. All right, we have a command hack. I'm all for it. What do we got here? Summon wolf? How is that a hack? Wait, what's this on the end here? Minecraft entity _born? Wait, is that a wolf you could actually change the color of? But apparently, by using this command, you don't actually have to use a mod. You can just use a vanilla in-game feature. So if we go summon and then wolf, --, and then what was it? It was Minecraft and then entity_born. There it is. We hit enter and oh my gosh, it is a red baby wolf. And I can turn it into orange and yellow and green. Oh my gosh, you can actually dye it. What are the other options here? We've got born wild. Whoa, what does that do? Okay, there is our regular wolf. Okay, I cannot dye this wolf here. I can't dye the full-sized one. That's a little bit odd. I can't even tame the full-sized one. That is really odd. But I can dye the baby one, which is just so cute. I want a little blue wolf. I just found this really cool trick that allows you to make a hidden ladder in Minecraft. Wait, did he just climb up that wall? Put down item frames and put any kind of map inside. Wait, they have to have a blank thing. And then on the edge of each one, you put vines. And you can suddenly climb up this invisible ladder? So I'm pretty certain that this will work. Like, I don't believe for a second this is clickbait, but the tricky thing is here, guys, if we put our item frames down, because if you go ahead and just grab out an empty map here, guys, open it up, well, it's gonna show something. And then you put that there, and then you can put a vine back there, and so I guess you can climb up maps, but it's not really an invisible ladder unless you're happy with seeing the map there, guys. So in order to do what they actually showed in the video, it's a little bit more complex. You gotta go TP off to some random area, and then if we go ahead and turn on our chunk borders like so, guys, you need to capture a certain amount of chunks in a space and basically replace them with whichever color you want. So if we come here to halfway through this chunk, we need to set one position just here, guys. So if we go ahead and build one block under, and then stand on top of it. We need to get one position there. 10 chunks just over here, over to this block. I think that should do it. And we need to fill this entire space with whatever color we want. So they used white. So we're gonna do that as well, guys. We're gonna use white concrete. Now we have a giant slab of white. And when we open up the map, you can see we've got this just plain white map. So now, when we come back to our item frames, we can put this plain white map inside the item frames and do exactly what they had in the video, guys, by putting our vines behind here and getting that really effective, you know, invisible ladder that they had going, which looks really, really cool. And I must say would be a great addition to modern houses, with the one disadvantage being is it's literally pure white. It's not quite the exact same white as white concrete, which can be a little bit odd looking, but I'm sure you guys can figure out a great way to use this as decoration. How to make a balloon in Minecraft. Wait, that's in-game? That looks like a mod. Wait a minute, you turn on education edition in the world create menu and that allows you to create balloons? Actually, I think I might remember doing this a long time ago. So you get a compound combiner here, guys, and you need to use carbon, hydrogen, and helium. Wow, we are testing my chemistry knowledge right now, guys. I haven't been in school. I've forgotten all this stuff. Okay, so you put it in this compound creator. You put in your carbon, 5 carbon, and you need to have 8 hydrogen. All right, that makes sense. And that will give you what, latex? Okay, and then, oh, balloons are made out of the stretchy latex. If you combine latex on the outside here, guys, and then you use what? You put helium in the center. Well, helium makes things float. You can put a lead at the bottom, a dye on the top, and that's gonna give you a red balloon. Does that mean you can get other colors of balloon? Okay, I'm gonna try this, and then you can send mobs to the sky. All right, so pretty straightforward. We need to create a new world, and when we do that here, guys, we need to come down. Oh, here it is, cheats, education edition. We turn that on. We need a compound creator, which is this weird looking block here, which is only in the education edition. Basically, I need to combine, what was it, 5 carbon, with 8 hydrogen, and by doing that, that's gonna give us latex. We can create an absolute ton of that, and then we're just gonna need your regular old crafting table, and we need to combine that with some dye, as well as a lead. So we'll try some red dye. I wanna see whether you can make different types of balloons as well, and then we'll need a lead to finish all of that off. All right, we've got all the items. We'll put down our crafting table. Now we'll grab our latex and we'll just put this on the sides here, just like they did in the video. All right, there we go. Latex on either side. We put our lead at the bottom, our red dye at the top, or was it in the middle? What goes on the... Oh, no, wait. We put the helium in the center and dye on the top, and there we go. We got ourselves a red balloon. And can I change the dye and get... Oh, look at that, guys. I can actually get different colors of balloon. Okay, wait. So I need to find a mob to put this on. Mr. Pig, you are my experiment. That is awesome. Okay, wait. I want to try this. All right, there we go. And we'll put our balloon on there. Yo, that is really, really dope. But guys, for our next clickbait hack, you're actually going to have to subscribe and watch the next video because that's all the time we've got for today. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, AOI stream out. Mwah!